Mark, well done. A really good win there. And what a difference from your last couple of games. You were saying your concentration was wavering in and out this week, but a really, really tough opponent in Michael White, and you've dealt with it in a great win.
Yeah, it was strange because I had about 3 hours sleep last night, and yet my concentration there was better than any of the other games I've played in. So, I don't know. But I mean, I played well. That's the main thing. I'd struggled the last few games, so I knew, obviously, I couldn't play any worse. At some point, I was going to have to try and find a bit of form. So thankfully, I did.
Yeah, you were saying you've been struggling a little bit with jet lag since coming back from Hong Kong, so it's a slightly difficult one to deal with this week.
Yeah. I mean, Bobby's came over with me as well, and speaking to him, and he said he's not had a great night's sleep since he's been back. So, I mean, we're just over a week now, so hopefully I'm coming out the other side of it, and I need a good night's sleep now for tomorrow.
Both obviously struggling with the sleep at the moment, but how nice is it to have Bobby back around, and the fact he's going to be here for the whole year? He's obviously a great, great friend of yours and someone you've not been able to see for a while, being in China with all the coronavirus stuff.
Yeah, it's fantastic. You know, I mean, obviously I've known Bobby since I was probably 9 or 10. We've basically grew up together. I mean, he's a few years older than me, but basically grew up together. And before Corona, like you say, I was seeing him at least once a year, if not in the China tournaments. He was coming out for the UK event, so I basically treat him like a brother. So it's great to have him back on the tour with us, and hopefully in China the restrictions can get stopped and we can get back out there and play tournaments out there as well.
In terms of this week, there's not many tournaments you've never won before, but this is one of them, and it feels like a really big tournament, this now. It's a brilliant venue here at the Waterfront, so it'd be a great one to try and win.
Yeah, it's a fantastic venue and a great city as well. So I think I got to the semi-final 1 year, lost to Ronnie 6-5. That's the furthest I've been. So, I'm in the quarters. Hopefully I can win a couple more matches and get to the one table set up. As you say, it's a great place to play. You know, obviously the crowds have been good this week, so I'm sure there'll be even more come towards the end.
Neil Robertson up next. You've had some great battles down the years, so that'll be a really good occasion tomorrow. Not a game we necessarily expect in the quarterfinals, but a great game for the fans to watch.
Yeah, for sure. Obviously, I need to be on top of my game, and if I'm on top of my game, then I've got a chance, you know. Neil's a great player, one of the all-time greats of the game, and we're in the same sort of management group, so I'm not sure who Stevie out in China will be cheering for, but hopefully it's a good game and met the best man win.
And I suppose quite a lot riding on it. You're in the same boat also in the fact that you're both going for that, trying to win here for the first time. So it's a sort of unique one for both of you to try and be adding a trophy to your cabinet.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, like me and Neil's won a lot of tournaments now. There's probably not many tournaments that we haven't won, obviously this being one of them. So I'm trying as hard as Neil, I suppose, to try and put that on your CV.
And having played against him in so many big matches, big finals, big semi-finals before, what would you class as, how do you tend to go about trying to play a player like Neil? He's so aggressive, but he's got a very good safety game as well, hasn't he?
Yeah, he's just got a good all-round game, you know. I think World Snooker put on Twitter earlier on who's the best long potter in the game, and I think Mark Williams put, obviously, Neil for certain, and I'd agree with that. And as you say, obviously, it gets him out of trouble a lot in his game. So he's tough to play against, but you need to be on top of your game, same as you do with any of the top boys. So I'll go out there, give it my best, and see what happens.
Well, we'll look forward to finding out tomorrow. Good luck.
Cheers, Robbie.